Hey, this is Chuck with BMW Blog, and in this video we're going to show you a DIY on how to change the 12 volt battery in your BMW i3 and point out some important differences between changing it in an all electric car versus a car with an internal combustion engine. And we'll also teach you how to register the battery to the BMW when we're done.
For this DIY, we're changing the battery on a 2017 BMW i3 with about 52,000 miles. Now, the most important part of doing this actually occurs a few days before you start the DIY, and that is to make sure that your battery is fully charged. In our case, it took about 36 hours of charging the Remy battery AUX18L, which cost about $140. It took about 36 hours on the trickle charger to become fully charged. Once the thing is fully charged, then you can start the DIY, but I definitely don't recommend installing the battery if it's not fully charged. Now, this is a longer DIY, but I did that so that there's a lot more detail in it. If you already know the spot, you can skip ahead. Just look at the chapters down below and we'll break down which part we're working on at which moment in the video.
So this part is a 4mm hex head. The torque on them is extremely low because they're secured into plastic, but you're not going to get it with your bare hands. It helps to have an Allen key or a socket set with a 4mm hex head for these. And then there's two more in the bottom of the bucket here. And then there are two more bolts right here, or little nuts. These are also 4mm hex that hold the very front in here, but just definitely be careful you don't drop them into the front of the bumper, or you're gonna have to get a magnet fish clip and pull it out. You should be able to wiggle it out here because the bumper's painted. You don't want to scratch the bumper. So the next step is to disconnect the high voltage battery, which is a really important step because this is unlike a gasoline powered car. We have to disconnect the power of the battery from being activated. So this is how BMW has put this to inactivate this when you take out this 12 volt battery.
So the connector on this one is right here, and then this comes down, and when it comes down you'll see this says off. When it says off, you're fine. And then right here, this little hole right there, you need to put something through it so it doesn't slide back and then fall and connect while you're working on it. So this is a 2021. This is quite a bit different. So this has a little red clip. You pull the red clip up and then that's how you disconnect it. Then you pull a hole. This red clip comes this way. And then the whole thing comes up this way and you've deactivated it. And on the battery, which is right over in here, and it's back up in there. We have to take that metal bracket out. So we'll take this bolt out first, then that bolt right there, and then we will slide the whole thing back, take the vent tube out, and then go from there. We need a 10mm socket, so I got a 10mm socket here. A little snug, but not too bad. I got a little longer extension for the one in the back. It's still a 10mm, but maybe don't even have it long enough yet. Oh, here we go. This works. So same thing, you want to be careful when the actual screw comes up, the bolt comes out, that you don't drop it deep into the car, so it'll be a pain in the ass to get it. So let's see if we can't get lucky and not drop it. There we go. So the bracket should just come out. There it goes. It's got little plastic things so it doesn't rattle. Where ya? Now, this is the sort of tricky part because I've seen a guy on YouTube break his vent tube. So we're going to have to be careful with that. But we'll probably take off the negative terminal first. Once we get the negative terminal off, we will find the vent and disconnect the vent. And then we will shimmy the battery back. Sure looks like it's gonna fit in. Yeah, there we go. All
All right, these things right here are the bomb. These are ratcheting wrenches. They are the best thing ever. They bust, they save your knuckles from being busted. They fit in really tight spots like this. So you set it to loose, set it on the top of the battery terminal. Hopefully you don't contact the positive and make it interesting. Pro tip is to take the filler tube off for the wiper fluid. It gives you enough room to actually get your hand in here. And we found then it was much easier to get the terminal off. And then another thing I like to do is take a glove and then just put the glove over the terminals so that they don't then start bumping in while you're actually, you know, you don't want them to contact when you're working on the other side. So I slip a little leather glove right around the terminal, and then there's no way that it can actually accidentally reconnect and then get yourself shocked. Even though it's kind of low voltage, it still wouldn't be fun. Weirdest thing, we can't find the vent tube on that battery, so we pulled the tray off the 2021 BMW i3, and it's got a vent tube, but it's all the way back there, and it's connected. Yeah, it's right, there we go. It's that little gray, it's this gray piece right there. That is a vent tube. BMW has used those for years because they put batteries in trunks. And when they put a battery in a trunk, they need to vent the gases from the battery out of the trunk so it doesn't rust. But really, you can actually see the ground if you look through here. So maybe it doesn't need to really vent as well, but we're obviously not replacing a 2021 battery, but it was interesting to see the difference. Let's wiggle this thing out and see. You just need to be able to basically get an angle on the top here, because this little BMW puts an explosive terminal, so if you get in a wreck, this thing will actually explode and blow off. So it'll disconnect the battery for the car, for gasoline-powered cars, that's important. But you gotta take this off, right? And to get access to it, you need to peel this back. And right there is the 10 millimeter bolt that we have to get off so we can get the positive terminal off the battery. Just a lot of wiggling back and forth. You loosen it, wiggle it, loosen it, wiggle it. And then after we get those off, we have to replace the terminal caps. So we loosened this one, which was 10 millimeters, and we couldn't get it off. And we realized that we had to get this other piece, this other one right here. So we loosened that a little bit, and then once we did that, then the whole thing came off, and now we just have to grab the battery and wiggle it out of there. There's not a lot of room. Well, that is interesting. There's a date on this one. So somebody replaced this in July of 2019, and I bet that's when the vent came out. So we'll look back here for the vent, but I don't see it yet. All right, so this is the one that came out of the car. This is the new one. So we need to take these little terminals off so that you can get the BMW connected. So they're kind of interesting. They look brass, which I would suspect that's what they are. They should probably just sit. Yeah, they just sit right on top of there, and then you drop this bolt in there, and then tighten it. Obviously, the torque is not very much on it. This one was hand tight torque, so we're not going to torque it down much when we put it on here. So again, brass, and just slips over there. It's like just a really cool way to connect it so that you have a little bit extra terminal to work with. And then very easy to tighten that on there into the engine bay, if you want to call it that. It's not even really an engine bay, but you kind of just wiggle it back here. So get it on the tray, supporting tray, and then turn it sideways. And then we'll center it, and then put the mounting bracket back on it, and then we'll get the
terminals back on it and then should be good.
All right, so we just realized something. When we put the terminals on, we noticed that they were on pretty loose, and we were concerned that maybe the install wasn't right last time. So when we put the positive terminal on this, on the car, and we installed it and tightened it down, we noticed that the red terminal right here, that it would slide back and forth. So we got out first some 10 millimeter sockets, and then with the 10 millimeter sockets, we tightened this down right there. That didn't stop it from wiggling. Then we tightened this top one. That didn't stop it from tightening. And then we went back, and then we decided to tighten the terminal down with a hex. And when we put this in the terminal, we noticed that the terminal had come loose. And now that's tight, now those are tight, and now this does not wiggle around. So that's not gonna give you any electrical faults, but I would for sure, when you install this thing, check all three. Check the terminal bracket, the brass bracket to the battery, and check the two 10 millimeter bolts, the nuts to the bolts. You know, double check all three so that you don't get any random electrical issues. So we're just wiggling the battery back into its seated position on the bracket back there before we put the clamp on the bracket, and then we have to install the negative. All right, so now we got that put on there, so we're gonna tighten this one 10 millimeter nut, and then we're gonna double check the top of this brass piece here again.
Once you've got the battery cables reconnected and secured, it's time to replace the vent tube.
All right, so this is kind of a tall battery, so you want to put the long part on the vertical part. And then when we took it out, we noted that the longer bolt was up top, and then the shorter bolt was down bottom. So we'll reinstall that, and then we should be in business. We just put these back together, and there's the top bolt is right up in the center, and then the bottom one is right here. The bottom one was pretty hard. We had to just kind of wiggle it around until it actually got purchased. But the top piece up here was, obviously a lot more straightforward, and this is a little bit longer, but we're just double checking that because we want the battery to rock and roll around and have pieces come, the terminals come loose over the years of driving. Right. Key to putting this on is making sure you get this the right direction, and you just kind of wiggle this around. There it goes. And then once that's in, then you want to just kind of click it so it's snug. But that extra space really made a big difference to the negative terminal to make it a lot easier. All right, so here is the part that we disconnected before we started the whole project. And right here it says off. And when we're done, when we close this back up into here, it's going to say on. And basically that's the high voltage battery disconnect. And so this little hex key is acted as a safety mechanism to make sure that we didn't accidentally connect the high voltage battery when we were working on this. And so we will see if we get lucky, if this just slides back in here, which it doesn't look like it's going to easily. All right, so we realized that to get the orange style, you just push this little tab here, and then once you push that, then you can then just simply push it together, which is a lot easier to do than the newer style, which is black and green. And so you'll notice that this is upside down. It looks like it says no, but it's actually on. So you just want to make sure that's good. And then you want to make sure that this hole right here is sealed up, because that's where the lock goes through. But you are re-engaged and the battery now is on. So all we have to do to finish up this project is reinstall the frunk
and register the new battery to the car via the Bimmerlink app or a service computer.
All right, so here's the ultimate acid test, as you turn the car on and hope that it all starts. So let's see if we get lucky. And really, this car has 57,000 miles, other than being mad that I don't have my seatbelt on and that we need to set the date and time. There really aren't any issues with it. It looks perfect. It looks like it did reset the trip odometer,
But otherwise, everything looks great.
For sure, you want to make sure that you register the battery. The car obviously functions fine, but you're going to get more long-term use out of the battery. And it's just better if you know, BMW has been doing that since maybe 2008. Makes it kind of a pain for the people like DIY stuff, but now you can buy an app and a Bluetooth connector. And then we're going to show you for part two of this how to do that.
So the next part we have to do is use this iCar adapter here, which communicates to your phone via Bluetooth so that we can tell the car that it has a new battery. BMWs are kind of funny. They want to know that the car has a new battery because fresh battery doesn't need maybe as long to quote start a car compared to an old battery, which might need to have the power drawn on it a little bit longer.
All right, so you go to the bottom of the car by the footwell, and once you get to the footwell, look up, and you're gonna see this little port right here, and then we gotta shove this little thing in there. You can see this kind of trapezoidal. You just wanna kind of make sure it matches up with there, and then kind of just wiggle it in nice and snug. You don't wanna push too hard, and you don't wanna push it if you find resistance, because you might have tried to put it on wrong or get it in wrong. So that's in there, and now we go to the cell phone to communicate with the car. We're using the Bimmerlink app, and this this little communication device is Wi-Fi, not Bluetooth. I misstated that. Then on the bottom there, it says register new battery, same capacity and type.
All right, so that is a little DIY on how to change the 12 volt battery on your BMW i3. Probably gonna get 4 or 5 years out of it. If your car's making a lot of weird things happening to it, like your alarm's going off in the middle of the night, or you're getting random errors on it, if you search those errors, you almost are gonna be guaranteed that you come up with that it's a 12 volt battery. It's a very easy DIY thing. There are a few tools which you need, which we will list in the description down below. And then I always think it's better to register your battery. You can do that with a thing called iCar. You snap it into the bottom and then you connect it with your phone, pay $35 for an app, and then you can register it. So that way the car knows the battery is new. BMW is really big on that, you know, have been for about 13 years. Anyway, if you like this video, make sure you click the like and subscribe button for us. And look forward to our next BMW i3 video where we're gonna flush the brake fluid on this one. Thanks for watching, cheers.
So right here is gonna be our next project. We're gonna do the brake fluid flush. This is something you need to do every 2 years.